Hello, everybody. It's Halloween week, so I hope you guys don't mind the costume. I thought you might as well do something fun. So if you guys are stressing about studying for the quality assurance exam, please do not stress. I know it's easier said than done. The best thing to do is to get started. Just go through the modules, go through the mock exams, and that will really help you. Things to focus on. So that's a very common question. They always change the exam. So I'm just telling you guys what I've heard about in the past and what people have told me has been on the exam topic wise. So WMIS, know your WMIS, know your infection control, know your sterilization. Oh my goodness, I cannot stress that enough. Know those things. As far as I know, you guys, COVID specific questions aren't necessarily on it. I don't want to say they're not on it because a lot of our infection control is still the same. It's not like we're you know, sterilizing differently. That we're doing the same, just PPE is something different. But technically, it wouldn't have been wrong to be doing that all along. So COVID-specific questions, I don't want you guys to get hung up on that and think you have to study 12 hours of COVID only. No. What I want you to do is, in general, infection control, sterilization, and WMIS. I'm going to be uploading another document next week with specifics for all of that. For those of you who didn't know, I'm going through an audit right now. So I've had to go through all of my manuals, policies, all of that, and update all of them. So it's the perfect time for me to share that knowledge with all of you guys too. Okay, what else? So I kind of left myself some notes on the other monitor there. You want to know about dental emergencies. Makes perfect sense. What to do if your patient might be having a stroke? What to do if your client's having a heart attack? What to do if your client's having angina? What to do if your client has fainted? Things like that. No emergencies. No fluoride. They love to talk about fluoride varnish. People ask me, silver diamine fluoride, is that on the exam? I don't know necessarily. I haven't really heard, but it's not that difficult to just study anyway. Silver diamine fluoride is a black liquid that arrests decay in primary and permanent teeth. It's not a permanent solution, meaning it's not a filling. You will still have to get a filling, things like that. But in a primary tooth, for example, when the baby tooth is going to fall out, that might be a very good option. I said emergencies, right? Yes, I did. You want to know gingivitis, perio, PSR. So if this has stressed you out, just simply saying that, stop the video. And well, this is almost done anyway, but you want to study all of that, you guys. Okay. Study. That's the best thing to do. Take those mock exams and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you guys. And I'll see you in the next one.